Another one, in this video we have one square, one quad circle, and one side of the square is given 3 units, and these two parts are given as equal. The question is, what is the length of the AE? Okay. If you notice that, we have a trapezium here, right? So AECB is a trapezium. Therefore, if you draw the middle base of the trapezoid like this, here must be equal 90 degrees, right? And we know that these are also 90 degrees. Moreover, these two parts are equal. That means these two parts are also equal to each other. So these are must be equal 3 over 2. After that, if we connect point B and point F like this, this length is also 3 units, and this length is also 3 units, right? Because of radius. Then, if you focus on this triangle, notice that ratio of these two sides is 2. That means this triangle is 30-60-90 spatial right triangle. So here is 30 degrees, this angle is 60 degrees, and here is 30 degrees. And if you notice that triangle ABF is an isosceles triangle, so these base angles must be equal 75 degrees. After that, if you connect these two corners, notice that these two lengths are equal, and here is 60 degrees. That means this side length must be equal 3 units. Right? So if you focus on this triangle is an equilateral triangle. Here is point F, right? So triangle BFC is an equilateral triangle. Therefore, here is 30 degrees, and here is 45 degrees, and this angle is 60 degrees, and 30 degrees left here. Next step, if you draw a perpendicular line opposite side of 45 degrees, let's call here X. So this length is also X unit, right? And if there's an X unit opposite side of 45 degrees, opposite side of the 90 degrees must be equal X root 2. So this part is also X root 2. And if you focus on this triangle, if there's an X unit opposite side of 30 degrees, opposite side of 90 degrees must be equal to X, right? Now also, if you focus on this triangle, if there's a 3 over 2, opposite side of the 30 degrees, opposite side of the 60 degrees must be equal 3 over 2 times root 3. If you notice that, this length is middle base of the trapezoid, right? So 3 over 2 times root 3 must be equal 3 plus 2x over 2. Therefore, if you simplify the expression, these are again, so 2x equal 3 root 3 minus 3. So if you notice that, the length of the AE equal 2 root 2 times x, right? So if you multiply by root 2, both sides of the equations, we get the length of AE. right? So the length of AE is going to be 3 root 6 minus 3 root 2. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye-bye.